Hey guys, Joe here, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, hi, I'm Joe, and welcome to my little vibe. So guys, today I'm just gonna update you on how life has been for the past month and some change, I would say. Living in South Korea, because your girl is now overseas. I'm not in the States, if you have not noticed. Yeah, I'm all the way out here, girl. You know what? Who knows? I'm coming to you raw and unfiltered and fresh out the shower and looking quite messed in some ways, but it's okay. I just need to get this video out to y'all. Before we get into this video, make sure you turn on that post notification bell so you can get notified every time I upload. If y'all are really interested in my life and you want to see what I got going on over here, go ahead and turn it on. You don't want to miss these, okay? Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and join the vibe, of course, because what are you doing? It's a whole little vibe over here, and we be chilling and vibing and drinking and smoking and linking and vibing and drinking. No, I'm kidding, but make sure you share with your friends. Follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, add me on Snapchat. Y'all know what it is. Yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, so me and, oh no, hubby and I, we moved out here about, I think it was June 21st. So it's like been a little bit over a month since we've been living here. If you didn't know, Bae, yeah, not gonna know his name, Bae. He's in the army, so that's why we live out here, just to catch y'all up to speed. Our first duty station, of course, is out here. This is our first time living together. We just hit 7 months of marriage. 7 months of marriage about a couple days ago, like last week. The army put us out here for his first duty station. We were supposed to be in Georgia at first, and then they switched it up and moved us all the way here, and I was able to come. So yeah, of course I'm gonna come. Also, I'm not like, I didn't really write anything down, just kind of just talking to y'all like off the dome. So far, I don't know, it's been really crazy. We're at Camp Humphreys. We live off post. We don't live on post because I think it was full anyway, and it's like PCS season, so not a lot of people are gonna be able to live on post, I guess. But when we were in quarantine, we were able to get answers about living on or off post, so we were already planning on living off post, period, because it's less restrictions and better living, I guess. We have had no issues, no problems in our apartment. And if you haven't seen my apartment tour, link in the description, girl. What are you doing? Link. It's really nice, and there's a lot of places like this out here. We're in a high-rise apartment, and we love it. It's just like a whole vibe. Still trying to get it together. We live on 18th floor. We're just like starting to really get comfortable, I guess. Like, you know, now that we're in here and been in here for a little minute now, it's just been feeling like regular, I guess. Like, it's nothing new. It's pretty cool, I guess. The only thing that's really catching us off guard is like the language barrier. I'm sorry, y'all, we really try. It's just really, I don't know, it's a hard language to learn. I know we don't expect these people to like speak English because we are in their country, so I'm not gonna expect the Korean just to know English and just be like, hey, how are you, what are you doing? Like, you know, especially when we go out to eat, most of the times we're greeting them, like we say 안녕하세요, because that's how you say hello, how are you? So that's what we say, you know, just to be respectful. We'd be like, "안녕하세요," and we said it to everybody just so they know, like, you know, we're having some common courtesy towards y'all, because we are here in y'all's restaurant, in y'all's store, whatever it is. Because even on post, a lot of the people working in like the PX or the commissary, anywhere on post, they're Korean, so they do speak Korean. A lot of them speak English, but then off post is a whole nother story. So where we live, like the area we live around, there's a lot of restaurants and food and this and that. So not most people speak English, which is fine, but we do pretty good, honestly. Let me tell y'all a story real quick. One time, I think it was like right before we moved in here, we were like just bringing our necessities that we got from the PX. Like, I bought a whole bunch of cleaning supplies and stuff, so we just like dropped it off and we had to stay at the barracks for one more night. So we went to this place by our complex that's called Mr. Burger, and we were craving some burgers. It sounded good, so we like, okay, let's go get some burgers. So we walked in and we're like, okay, smell good in here. She gave us the English menu, okay, cool. But we were like, we don't want pork burgers, like we want beef. So I'm pointing to the beef. I'm like, I want beef, this, that. We couldn't get by like exactly how to tell her, and she couldn't understand us, unfortunately. So, and this was before we were even using any app or anything like Papago or whatever, like I mentioned. Oh, I didn't mention it, but we use Papago. This video is not sponsored, but if you're in a foreign country, get Papago. It can translate pictures, voice memos, and just anything from whatever language to English or English to whatever language. So we use that a lot when we go to restaurants. We just type in like what we want to say and it goes right up. Or like a lot of our appliances have, you know, Korean writing. So like take a picture of it and it'll translate it. Okay, so anyway, we didn't use the app, right? So we got our burgers, right? First of all, the fries were bussin'. Fries are really good, bomb. But the burger, it was a pork burger. And there was like pineapples and mustard and this and that. And that's just like a lot of shit that we didn't eat, especially on a burger. And I was like really disappointed because we really wanted the burger, but it's whatever. Other than that, everywhere else we go, we just like point to the menu and they really understand. It's like not that big of a deal, but sometimes it can get frustrating not knowing. Or a lot of the times when we go out to eat, there's a lot of food being passed on. Like they bring out a lot of side dishes for our meals and we don't know what they are, let alone what they taste like. So I don't know, it's really crazy, honestly. It's pretty cool, it's pretty dope. I love it so far. We've been doing a lot of like walking around our neighborhood and just trying different restaurants because, you know, I wanted to be able to try different foods and stuff, especially with my husband. Like, there's something we get to check off our bucket list is trying new food in a foreign country. That's what we're doing. That's exactly what we're doing, is trying all different types of food. We tried like 5 different places so far, I think. Because look, y'all, we're not eating out every night. Like, what do you think this is? The prices vary. Also, we use won out here. Won, W-O-N. We use won, so the money is different. I think I have something to show you. If you like don't want to use your card, I use my card a couple of times out here, like off post. I pull out cash sometimes so we can like, you know, pay in cash and not use my card and get those international fees. This is like 50,000 won. Official. I think this is like $50 and 2 of these is like $100, right? And then this is 10,000 won. So how they taught me how to like use the money is just like take off the last 3 zeros. So it is like $10, you know, but it's not exactly $10. It's probably like $8.57, you know, like, it's not exactly $50, it's probably like $45. I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments down below because, yeah, I'm still struggling. I just get the price and I pay, and then, or if I use my card, I'll like see the exact price that I paid and it'll be like $87.50. Like when I pulled out 100,000 won, it was like $87 in US dollars. So I was like, okay, well, that's a little confusing, but I'm getting the hang of it now. It's pretty straight to the point, pretty straightforward. We use won a lot now. Bae always has won in his wallet because he don't mess with that using his card anywhere else, which is okay. He'll use it on post. Like I said, we'll use it on post, but I kind of strayed away from using my card off post also. Oh, we finally got an APO box. I don't know if I'm able to like link that if y'all want to send me stuff. And I'll like do an APO box opening. But that's like our address. It's not to here, it's like to the post office on post, like a PO box. APO box, I don't know what that means, but look it up if you want to. So yeah, if you want to send stuff, go ahead and send it my way, girl, cause I'll open it for you and show everybody on my YouTube channel, okay? So we finally got that, so I'm able to order Amazon things also. Oh, that's another thing, so ordering off of Amazon. I have Prime, right? And I'm still paying for Prime, whatever, because I'm not gonna wait a whole month for something that I want right now. Not just something I want right now, but like stuff for the house. Like I ordered some nightstands and like a lamp and stuff like that. I ordered that about last week, I think. Yeah, so with Prime, it's taking about 10 days. So it comes next week on the 17th and 18th, which is fine. It's quicker than a month, but like, you know, Prime back in the States is like 2 days type shit. So, oh, I'm just gonna wait it out. I don't have to order things off of there that I like need urgently. I can just go to the PX for that or go to like a little market around here. Oh, also I ordered something off Shein. It's gonna take a month to get here. Like I ordered that last week as well. It's not coming until like August 31st. That's the estimated delivery date. So that's gonna be a video though. Coming soon, wait for my Shein. So anyway, that's not the point. Things take a while to get here. Like I said, I'm gonna link my APO box down in the description if you wanna send me something and have me open it on my video. I would do that for you, babe. I got you. Yeah, what else? The driving. I don't drive. I'm more like a Rapunzel type of bitch. I stay in the house. not like that, but like I don't really work right now, so I just like stay at home. And if I wanted to go outside, I could. But the reason why I don't just go outside, let me tell you, don't just think I'm being held hostage at the house, because I'm not. We have like a panel, right, that unlocks the door and gives us the code to get into the building, because we only have one key card. And I think I have to pay for another one if we want one. I didn't ask though. There's one key card and then we can set up a code, but we didn't get to set that up yet. Because when our realtor came and tried to do it, I don't know why they didn't know like how to change it, but it was because the previous tenant's code was still in there and they didn't know it. But we got the old utility bill from the previous tenant, which had the code on there. So I'm gonna change it myself so I can at least be able to like go walk around and, you know, do little things just cause. But it's a little hot anyway, so I like to just stay in the house, chill, clean, do laundry, watch YouTube videos, you know. And then like when Bae gets home sometimes, he'll take me out. I chose not to drive though, y'all, so don't think it's like that type of situation, because it's not. I just don't want to drive out here. I'm kind of really anxious about it. Just the way they drive, it's kind of crazy, a lot of different places. Bae's kind of starting to drive like them too, so I just choose not to. And if I want to, we're gonna be here for 2 years, so if I want to end up driving, I can go get a car and start driving out here. It wouldn't be a problem. But the thing is, just getting back into the house was the issue. So regardless of driving, I can't even get back into the house without a key. So bad work. I can't get in without a key or a code, but we're gonna set up the code one day. We just keep forgetting about it. Oh, I don't know if you noticed. Okay, TMI, my armpit hair is growing out. Anyway, I haven't like found any, what is it called? Estheticians or nail shops or anything, but I just found a few people. I booked some appointments, girl, because I was like, oh no, I'm not gonna go sad. I've been like totally over my hair, but it's growing out. Y'all see? It grow a little puff off. I found somebody that does eyebrow threading, eyelashes, and she's gonna do eyebrow lamination to me. I go there on Wednesday. I'm gonna vlog that as well. I found a nail shop. They do all type of shit in there. Facials, Brazilian, sugar waxing, girl. Manicure, pedicure, full sets, everything. Massage, everything, hair. So I'm gonna go there. It has really good reviews and it's like right next to Camp Humphreys. I'm gonna have to go there too so I can get my feet done. I'm gonna give my fingernails a break right now because they need to get strong and healthy again. But I might just get like a cool little manicure or whatever. But then I found a hair braider. Oh my god, let me tell you guys, I didn't know what I was gonna do with my hair because I was like tired of doing it. Some days it really looks a hot mess and I'm just tired of it, and it's just been feeling like a braids type of year. I'm gonna get these braids again and leave them in, and my hair is kind of like at an awkward length right now. I want it to grow a little bit more before I start wearing it out and styling it like how I used to. I found a braider. I go next weekend to get my hair braided, girl. And let me tell you about this. They're gonna be knotless. And she provides the hair. And she's gonna wash and blow dry. Tell me about that, hope. Y'all braiders need to get it together. If you provide the service, you need to provide the full service, baby. And that's okay if the price is a little bit higher, because you're giving me the full service and I will pay for that. But anyway, yeah, I found all my little plugs. And I'm gonna get right for the get right, because I'm tired of looking crazy. Even if I just sit in the house all day, I just wanna like look good for myself, because I've been feeling ugly lately. I don't know why, like this whole past week I was just feeling really ugly, and I'm like, no girl, get together. So girl, I got on Instagram and I was looking up hashtags. That's how I found these people. I looked at their work, I was looking at all that, and next thing you know, boom, booked, period, just like that. So it wasn't too hard. Just a month in, I wasn't really thinking about it before, but now I'm like, okay girl, it's time. Okay, oh, let me tell you another thing, y'all. The produce out here, like in the Korean markets, are way better than the produce like on Camp Humphreys. Everything's different, even the water is better. We have a whole fresh water purifier because that's just how he is. It's really clean. Also, I went to the dentist. I had to go off post because they wouldn't allow me to go on post, which I don't know why, so they provided me like a list of dentists that take TRICARE. So I went to the dentist and I'm actually going back tomorrow for them to finish their work on my teeth, because y'all, I've got cavities. But it's okay, let me explain. I have cavities because I didn't have health insurance before. Okay, yeah, it sounds crazy. I didn't, I was fucking broke. I couldn't afford that shit. The government insurance that I had, like the little Medicaid shit, that shit didn't cover no type of work to get done at all. So I was like struggling for a couple years. Finally, I was able to go to the dentist, and I've been saying it and saying it and saying it for like the past couple of months before I even came out here. I was trying to go to the dentist when I was in Rayford. It didn't happen because my dental wasn't activated yet. So I finally found one They clean my teeth, my first appointment. I went for a second appointment and they put a temporary like filling in this one tooth back here. I go back tomorrow and they're gonna give me a porcelain filling. Hopefully later down the line they can like fit me for some more retainers. They finally took out this like little piece of permanent retainer I had that broke years ago. They drilled it off so I can start fresh. I'm trying to get another retainer just so I can close my gap. But y'all, their teeth out here are perfect. Like Dr. Kim's teeth are perfect. She like, let me see your teeth. Oh, it's a little gap. I'm like, girl, I know. I know I got a gap, girl. She's been taking really good care of me, her and her whole team. So tomorrow I'm gonna go back, finish up my work, and then hopefully I'll be able to do everything else that I want to do out here. Cause that second day after getting that work done, I was sick, I was over it. I haven't seen any other type of like doctor about anything, cause I don't really need to right now. I feel fine. I might go to like the fucking optometrist or something to get glasses because my eyesight is pretty bad, but it's not really a necessity for me right now. Like I'm not blind, I just need something to like help me see a little bit better. I think that's it, guys. Let me know if you have any more questions down below, and of course I'm gonna answer them. Also comment down below, what do you guys want to see next? Because I want to know what you guys want to see, and I would definitely like to try and put that out for you. Not try, I would definitely like to put that out for you girls. So comment down below what you want to see and I'm gonna do it, and you gonna you don't get it, okay? That brings us to the end of this video. Make sure you turn on the post notification bell so you can get notified every time I upload. Like, comment, subscribe, and join the vibe. Girl, what are you doing? Follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter. Add me on Snapchat, y'all know what it is. Also, if you're on Camp Humphreys and you wanna make a friend, text me, girl. Reach out to me, DM me something, because I need friends. So yes, of course, I will see you guys in the next video.